divine child is witnessing.
So the divine child is knowing that there is eating going on.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. So then any eating has two parts. Okay? Mm. You repeat me.
Yeah.
I am
eating.
Banana. This is a thought.
Yes.
Okay? Mm. I am aware.
I am aware
that I am eating banana. So there are two steps in this.
Yeah.
One is I am eating banana. That I am aware that I am eating banana.
Yes.
Okay. Mm. So now who says I am aware that I am eating banana?
Divine child
says I am aware that I am eating banana. It doesn't say.
Yeah.
Silent.
Yeah, silent.
Okay. Mm. I am eating banana. Who says so?
Human child.
The society child.
Yeah, the
thought. Okay. The divine child says, I am aware that I am eating banana. So suppose divine child is not there. Then society child can say, I am eating banana. Can it say?
No.
Okay. The I am eating banana is a thought. Right? The society child doesn't know. The knowing is happening for the divine child. I am aware that I am eating the banana is a divine child. Okay.
We may not always be aware, right?
It's always aware.
Because so that's not something we experience. That
no. You don't have attention. You are confusing attention with awareness. We'll find out what is the difference between attention and awareness. Okay. Awareness is always on. Awareness never switches off. Attention changes.
You mean like I can rent to my breath, then I can rent to my belly. This is attention, not awareness.
Not awareness.
But we say, right, we are becoming aware of the breath.
Baba, the idiots will say so many things, sir. You have to be very clear what you are speaking of. There are so many things are floating around.
This is confusing attention and awareness.
The attention is taking your awareness to specific direction. It's a job of the mind. Awareness is knowing. Okay? Awareness is never switched off. That's the divine child. You'll find out. So, are we clear? So anything has two aspects. I am eating banana is a thought. I am aware that I am eating banana is knowing the divine child. So now if you ignore the divine child and I am eating banana, you say I am body, then it's a materialistic experience. You cut the experience into materialistic.
But one is aware, another is eating. Where is the experience coming into picture?
The eating experience is I know eating experience happening. Everything I know, experience is happening, thinking is happening, knowing is happening, is I know. I am the knowing principle. Okay? Right? So now, people say spiritualistic, this is materialistic. Materialistic means they have forgotten the consciousness. Okay? Then they say, eating banana is materialistic. Right? Then there is a spiritualist. Then what do they say? I am spiritualist. I don't eat banana. Okay? Banana is materialistic. I am consciousness. He is ignoring the matter part. So once you bring both together, there is neither spiritual nor material. Everything is divine. One. Are you clear? The life is divine. It's neither material nor spiritual. If you don't understand this, okay, I want to go get out of materialism. So then I'll leave money, I'll leave family, I go to mountain, wear some dress, sit somewhere, I don't eat banana because it's material. I don't touch money. You're cutting life into two, matter and spirit. It's not two, it's one, Advaita, non-dual. It's a seamless experience. There's the experience and the knowing of experience. If there's no knowing, there's no experience. The knowing is consciousness, divine. Okay? Experience is matter. Okay? Are you clear? So there are two types of experience in our life. Sorry?
So the human child, I am eating banana is that of
thought.
The
thought process.
I am aware is that of the divine child.
Consciousness.
Yeah, but actually the one who is absorbing that banana is the human body.
Yeah, but human body cannot absorb, no, without consciousness. It's a dead.
The experience, you ask whether, what about human body does he experience? So, human body experiences?
It can happen only in the presence of consciousness.
But that experience is not that of human body.
Even in the presence of consciousness,
it is experienced.
In the absence of consciousness, there's going to be no experience. Now, whose experience is that?
Divine.
Please listen carefully. In the presence of consciousness, human body can eat a banana and say, I am happy or unhappy.
Yeah.
You can say. In the absence of consciousness, human body cannot eat banana or not experience. Now, who is the experiencer?
Experiencer is the divine
self. This is very clear, no? You're very, listen to your question carefully. In the absence of consciousness, human body cannot eat.
Yeah.
In the presence of consciousness, human body can eat.
No, human body can eat, but cannot experience. In the absence of consciousness.
How? Right?
It can eat.
How can it eat?
No, it
means dead body can
dead
eat?
Body can.
No.
Combination.
Okay, I'll give it in another way. Okay? In the presence of electricity, the light, bulb gives the light and fan rotates.
Yes.
Okay? And I get the light or I get the wind.
Yeah.
Electricity doesn't give the light. Fan give the elect, bulb doesn't give the light. Right? Okay? So, presence of electricity makes the light give to, bulb to give the light.
Yeah.
Okay? Similarly, the consciousness doesn't eat food. Divine child doesn't eat food. Human body cannot eat food
without
consciousness. Consciousness. Now, when both are there, the food eating is happening. Are you clear?
Yes.
So now, who is eating food? Who is experiencing?
Divine child.
Nobody is.
We'll come to this now. Forget about human body. It's too complicated. The bulb cannot give light without electricity. Electricity itself cannot give light. Okay? Electricity doesn't know what is light. Bulb doesn't know what is electricity. In the presence of electricity, bulb is giving light. Now, who is giving light?
Combination of electricity.
The electricity has a very, very different characteristic compared to bulb. Bulb is of different characteristic.
Electricity in the presence of bulb is giving light.
Who is giving light? You have to give the answer. What is the answer?
Both together.
Shravan?
Bulb is giving light because of electricity.
Bulb has no ability to give light. Bulb doesn't know electricity.
Experience in reality.
In reality, there is no experiencer. There is only experiences. Because consciousness cannot say, I am experiencer. Okay? The body cannot say, I am the experiencer. There is only experience. But there is somebody who claims that I am experiencing. Who is that fellow?
Society child.
There is a claimer, but there is no experiencer.
Guruji, repeat it again.
See, the consciousness, Chaitanyam or divine child doesn't eat food, banana. It doesn't even know the banana exists. Okay? The body cannot understand banana without consciousness. Body cannot understand consciousness also. Body is inert. Okay? There's a eating happening. You say, I am eating. Okay? I am eating banana. It's a thought. Correct? Now you are referring to the body is eating banana. Is it correct?
No.
Body cannot eat banana without consciousness. Is consciousness eating banana?
No.
Somebody is eating banana.
Before lunchtime. Okay. So consciousness is eating banana? No. Electricity doesn't even know light.
Yeah.
Okay. Bulb doesn't know electricity. Right? What is it? Got it?
Conscious body is eating.
Body cannot be conscious. They are totally opposite of each other. Inert and conscious. How can it be together? So
it's
there
only
is a
experience.
Huh?
She said there is no experience. I said there's only experience.
Ah. There's only experience, but there's a claimer of experience.
Claimer.
The claimer is the ego. Which doesn't exist because it's claiming something from consciousness, something from matter. Are you understanding? Uma? It's too heavy?
Heavy. Too much.
What is it? See, I'll tell. Repeat, okay?
Okay.
There is only.
There is only
experiencing.
Experiencing.
There's no experiencer.
Sir.
Ego?
Ego
is the claiming
claimer
as experiencer.
Ego.
Ah, which is not doesn't exist again. Okay.
Can we use the same electricity bulb analogy?
Yeah, go ahead.
For say watching movie.
Watching movie. Uh-huh.
So the movie is being projected on the screen.
Right.
That screen is something like consciousness. Without that, you can't project.
Correct.
Then, movie is being seen.
Right.
By someone who is sitting in.
Right.
But if the person doesn't have consciousness, he can't watch the movie.
Yeah.
He can't.
Right?
Yeah.
So, who is experiencing?
Who is experiencing? Tell me. There is no experiencer. Okay? There's the experiencing. Life is set of experiencing. Okay? Life is set of only experiencing. Various experiences. There is a constantly claimer. I am experiencing. That's called ego. Okay? There is no doer in life. There is doing in life. There is no thinker in life. There is thinking in life. Then what are you? Who are you?
But ego is required to judge whether the experience is good or bad, right?
Ego doesn't exist.
But it existed for a purpose, right? We created it after a purpose.
Who created it? Nobody.
Language, right? Maybe.
See.
So that we can run away from negative.
No, no. Who is we? Who is we?
I
can. Who is I?
The mind.
Are you the mind I? Are you the mind?
I'm not.
So then who is I?
It's an individual entity created by language.
See, it's a transactional entity.
Transactional entity. But
it's
important also, right?
Transaction entity is required for transaction. It appears and disappears every moment. But as a virus, it claims the identity of you, I. That's the problem.
But using it as a transactional entity and for benefit, that is not wrong.
Did I say something is right or wrong? I'm telling only fact. I never said that it will not be useful. I only said what's happening. The transactional entity who is as your servant is claiming I am the master. So what's happening is there was a master. Okay, he went for foreign trip, 6 months. Okay. Then he had 5 servants. And the master went out. One of the servants said, I am the master. He started using dress of the master. He started sleeping on the bed of the master. He asked other servants to take care of him. Okay. One day after 6 months, master comes back. Suddenly all servants are silent. Then one servant started impersonating the master. He is not a master. That's exactly what's happening. Ego is a transaction entity who is supposed to do some work. After doing the work, it has no role. But that guy starts impersonating the master, says I. Okay, master doesn't do the work. Servant is not the master. Servant is transaction entity, appears and disappears for that job. Then who is the doer? There is no doer, but there is a doing. There is no experiencer, but there is an experience. There is no thinker, but thinking is there.
Hello, Otto.
Just stop that, right?
Yeah.
Hello? Namaskar.